Hi guys, I hope you all are doing well. So welcome back again in this YouTube channel. So if you remember in our last video, we push our SCCM client with the help of client push from SCCM server. So now in this video, I'm going to show you that how you can create a group policy and push SCCM client on your Windows client computer. So first we need to log on our SCCM server. So now we need to create a folder for client. So I'm going to create a new folder. If you have any specific drive, you can create this folder on that drive. I'm going to create a SCCM client folder. Right click on this folder, choose properties, sharings, advanced sharing, share this, permission. So by default is everyone. So in like a organization, is best practice you need to remove everyone and you need to add a authenticated user, but I'm doing this in my lab, so it's not a big deal. But I would like to recommend that you need to remove this and add a authenticated user only. So I added a authenticated users and give a full permission. Now click apply and okay. There is another best practice, you can put dollar sign. So this will make a hidden. So we don't need that. Just apply, okay, and close. So now again, we need to make sure we are still in SCCM server. So open a C drive, program file, configuration manager, bin, i386, and type a CCM setup. Okay. So we need to copy MSI file, not a exe one. Okay. Just copy this file and go back C drive. So recently we created this SCCM client, so paste it here. So now we done for a SCCM server. Now we need to switch back to our DC. So let me connect my DC. So guys, now we need to switch back to our DC. So as you remember in our last video, we applied, like we installed a client push on Windows 10 PC1 by client push. So if you remember, I moved this computer in a SCCM and I told you that I will use this computer for a different purpose. So now I created another workstation OU by GPO. It's just friendly, so I can remember that what I'm going to do. So if you have already predefined OU, so you need to make sure you create a GPU for that specific OU. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm just moving this object to my new OU. So now we need to open a group policy for server manager, tools, group policy, and expand your forest, domain, and site. Okay, so expand your area where you want to implement this policy. If you want, you can apply entire organization, but if you implement this OU in entire your organization, and if you have a server like a dedicated computer which are running with some kind of application, this policy will also apply on all those computers. Okay, so it's a best you can apply this group policy for specific OU as per your requirement. Okay, so I'm going to create this group policy for this workstation by GPU. I just created this random name, so right click here. So I'm going to type SCCM GPU. Okay, you can name it what you want. Okay, so I just created a GPU. Just right click on GPU, click edit. So go to computer configuration and then policies. Administrative templates. So right click on administrative template, add remove templates. So add. So click on add and enter your SCCM server. Hit enter. We need to select the site code. So SMS STP is my site code. Just open it. So scroll down. Tools, configuration manager, ADMT templates. So we need to select these both and click open. Okay, and click on close button. So now we need to expand this classic administrative template AMD ADM and configuration manager. Just right click on configuration manager and just give me a second. So as we enable this, and we need to assign a site, that is my site code STP, and click apply and okay. So now we need to configure this configuration manager client deployment setting. It's not required, but if you can define this setting, your policy definitely will apply on client computer. If you don't want to implement this and you see that there are some error, then you can configure this later. Okay, so now I'm going to create this setting now. So just write edit enable. So here we need to define our setting. Just let me copy and paste. So we need to type ccm setup.exe space forward slash mp, then mean management point is my server name sccm, then space, make sure we don't have a double space, SMS site code, and in our case my site code is a STP. So just apply and okay. So it's done. Now we need to expand our software settings, software's installation. Click on software and new package and type your SCCM server name. Hit enter. So SCCM client which we have recently created and shared, and select the file MSI file and open it and make sure it's assigned. Okay, and we are done at this moment. So now we need to switch back to our client computer and let's see how this works. So the best thing that update the group policy. gpupdat/force, hit enter. So now let's back to our client. So this time we need to apply this policy on workstation GPU. Okay, so I'll show you that which computer is part of this. So if we click here, so Windows 10 PC2 is part of this group policy. Okay, switch back to our. So now we log on to our client computer. CMD. And we'll check the computer name by typing host name. You can see it's a PC02. So let's update the group policy. GP update space /force. So now it's updating policy. So to make this video short, I'm going to pause this. So now you can see that the group policy has updated successfully. So we need to restart our computer. So click on yes, hit enter. So now computer is going to reboot. So guys, computer rebooted. So now I need to open a task manager and we'll see if, yeah, so you can see that CCM setup.exe is running. As I said you that you can run a SCCM tray, so open a SCCM server. So you need to define your credential. So my credential are ADM STP, and my password is confidential. I'm not going to share with you, and it's best practice you will never to share your password with anyone. So you need to open a SCCM setup, SMS STP your code, tools and CCM trace. So it's my just quick question that which log you need to open, just mention the comment. So I want to see your answer. So you need to open a C drive, Windows and CCM setup. Okay, and you need to define a permission. If you don't have admin access, you need to provide admin access to access these log. So CCM logs. Okay, so now you can see that it's working, and I mean to say that it's start installation, and now it's installing. It's copying file from your SCCM server and to your client computer over the network. So may this will take some time. So I'm going to pause the video. I'll be back. So if you see any kind of error, you can explore about that error. So it's not a big deal. So now you can see that SCCM setup exiting with this error code. So error code is 0 is a successful code. So that means we have installed client via group policy successfully. So let's see how we can check that our client is installed or not. So go to control panel. And view by category, we need to choose a small icon, configuration manager. So guys, you see that now we have installed this client on our another Windows 10 computer with the help of group policy. So another way to check the group policy is applied or not, open a command prompt. Type rsop.msc and you can see that is processing. So under software setting you need to right click here, choose properties, and if you see any kind of error message that will be displayed here. So right now there is no error, so that means group policy infrastructure completed successfully. So click close. So there is another way to check that SCCM client is installed on our SCCM client. So switch back to our SCCM client. So now I'm logging to my SCCM client, open a System Center Configuration Manager. Asset and compliance devices. So now you can see PC2 is like a PC2. We have a client now. So guys, in this video we are implement or install our SCCM client on endpoints, or you can say that Windows client computer, with the help of group policy. So thanks for watching this video. If you like the content, please subscribe our channel and share with your friends. So that's it. Have a nice day. Bye bye.